match up against Oxygen 7-2.
Getting to the bans here, constantly going to be an interesting one. A map that we actually haven't seen getting played super often for at least the two of us here. I think we only get double cast like two or three times so far this season. So a welcome opportunity to be able to jump back into it here and check out both of these teams' progress one final time at the end of the stage. Nomad going to be our first operator being knocked out. We've seen her eliminated from the pool quite a few other times inside of Consulate this season. Just that flank watch utility being too powerful, specifically on this map with the predictable rotate positions. So we'll see her removed, you know, on the note of predictability. Thatcher following that one up pretty much immediately as well.
Yeah, and this is just following suit with all of their bans that we've seen in the past. This one's going to be a new one here from TSM, as regularly on their defenses, they've been banning Valkyrie or Wamai, but they're actually going to leave the Valkyrie up for Disrupt, so they'll choose to see if that one stays in the map. Cool, so could be a pretty decently sized fold, but not going to actually pan out. Maestro and Valkyrie removed from the defense, which means we're actually going to have Wamai on board for this.
Indeed we are. That means all of the utility mitigation operators for the defense will be available. We had that in our last game too, and we saw all three of them get picked up at least once. We'll see if Disrupt or TSM is going to favor that specific choice inside of this matchup. We'll go into our first round, though. We're not going to get it immediately, as we're going to a basement defense. Utility mitigation not going to be as important here. In fact, none of it will be brought to the table. It's more anti-drone that seems to be the focus on the utility front right now from Disrupt, as they're going to bring both a Mozzie and a Mute to the table. We will see the Cade brought initially, but it's looking like that's going to get six picked, and we've got an even more exciting one. Merc wants us to know about it, too, as he triple locks it here, as the Amaru pick is coming in for him.
Talk about it. I want you to talk about this. I'm going to do something very interesting, I promise. At least I hope it is. You know, this is actually pretty funny because we don't see Amaru picked literally ever. And the funny thing about it is that she actually did come into meta for a split second on this particular map. But what we saw from her was a lot of hatch plays where, in particular, on the top floor, a lot of teams would bring her, push into piano, and then shoot up the cubby hatch or the cabinet hatch, whatever you call it up there. And actually end up putting a plant down with smoke coverage and somebody on the console windows. So obviously they're going to be downstairs, so this is going to obviously give Merc a couple of issues, but he can still get early map pressure, and that's something that Amaru's always just been really, really good at. She's instantaneously inside of the map, unless obviously she dies on that entry.
So we've got TSM spawned out across the map. Roam setup still alive and well on the extended first and second floor holds from Disrupts. Obviously, that will need to be dealt with. Merc, I'm going to look to help out with that relatively quickly here with the Amara. More than likely not going to see that rope immediately used to swing, or hook, excuse me, immediately used to swing up towards the roof here, just because it would kind of ruin the surprise. So we'll have to wait and see. And that Gara hook is going to come into play here for TSM, and I will try to insert the Amara into the play here.
Well, the good news is he can at least shoot at things, because, you know, somebody else does have the G8. Looks like Merc's going to use the Gara hook for the very first time here as he flies into bathroom. That's a pretty strong cutoff here if anybody is playing inside a projector, in which someone is. He'll be able to get rid of the camera as well, so that's inside on Merc's location, as he'll take control of top yellow. Starts pushing towards connector, though, as Retro might run into some issues. He's immediately going to drop the hatch. He'll be able to get rid of the drone at a minimum and actually escapes away from TSM, as Disrupt is doing a very good job of backing off their roam game and keeping people alive.
So at minimum, the TSM choice to bring Amaru into the fold here has certainly helped out with clearing out the second floor. Upon that hop, we immediately saw Merc drop down to piano, and only a couple seconds later, Retro Jane, I know the other player holding on the inside of projector, also had to fall back relatively quickly as well. Now, there's still going to be problems, though. Merc has the bunker set up on the inside of the bathroom, and I believe the hatch is reinforced, if I saw it correctly. Was it?
Well, the thing is that there really is no bunker setup. There's
the
not a
problem.
Single reinforcement here. It's just him, and he's got a reinforced hatch.
Yeah.
So he's like, they can shoot
so
him any wall
he's
right
playing,
now.
He's playing to try and trade out at a minimum here, but as we're about to see, that's not going to be the easiest task in the world. Although they assume he's going to swing from playing to the inside instead of playing from the breach. They're still not able to get a kill, but he does some serious damage to achieved at least.
I don't even know if that wall is considered to be wood anymore with the amount of lead that just flew through that. That was just ridiculous from TSM. And luckily enough, Merc also having the G8 with a pretty deep magazine as well. They'll be able to keep Achieve alive, which means he'll be able to at least assist in breaking up this top floor, but also right on Death's door. So TSM needing to move pretty quickly here as Merc is taking control of yellow once again, but this time on the bottom level. He used that Gone 6 to get rid of the Banshee so he can progress forward if it's a necessity, but as of right right now, it doesn't seem to be the case. He can simply wait for TSM to get this garage open, possibly get some smokes in and go for an attempted plant. Geo, so strong so far this season on the plants. 9 so far as he is behind Luke, currently sitting at 11. If they're able to get 3 of those on their offense, that'll be the most plants inside of the season here for Stage 1.
Disrupt's still ready for the pressure to broil out against them at any moment here, and you're going to see that come into the fold now as we reach the last 15 seconds and TSM are forced into a play. Merc with a great shot selection eliminates Shuttle, and Chala as well able to take down Retro, but the trades are still coming in too strong. They're able to even this all out. Still no plant opportunities being presented. They're going to try it one more time. Achieve getting a nice cutoff against Iconic, but unable to guarantee the kill, and the flying Nitro Cell will finish things off as both Bolo and Achieve fall at the end there, and a successful defensive round is picked up by Disrupt.
That's extremely well done from Disrupt there. Honestly, the only even halfway mistake, if you can even say, was Mark being inside a bathroom, but he almost got a kill there as well. Like, that was just, you know, very, very poor engagements there on both ends. He just really couldn't find the angle necessary. But either way, Disrupt do a very good job of respecting the roam clear from TSM, especially given that Merc inserted so early on, right in the bathroom, able to get that really deep set so that they can't try and rotate back through flag or, you know, pressure connect or anything. So obviously Retro has to leave through the projector hatch. Everyone else trying to dip, dash, and dodge right out of that top floor. Leave Mark there, and he even delays more time translating TSM to that low time to execute, where the smoke grenades were just too much to deal with, especially coming in on top of the crossfires the Disrupt had set up.
A good waste of time coming in from Disrupt, despite the relatively early clear of the second floor roam game there. They're still able to delay quite potently, especially with their smoke chargers as well coming out towards the end of the round there. Really did some serious damage against the push from TSM, and certainly stopped their initial plant attempt as well as some of the initial map control they were looking to take inside of that site there. Slowing things down too much, obviously sounding the alarm for Disrupt in that final couple second execute as well, and giving them all the info they needed to shut down the play, putting that first round on the board. We are going to see them shift towards the split site next, although there is a lot of emphasis going into the upstairs hold right now. To be fair, that's what we normally expect. We're going to see a lot of it here. A Rooney Gates going down into the copier doorway, multiple reinforcements. I believe that's a mirror window on the inside of the closet, of copier closet here as well. So Mark will be able to play off of that. This is going to be a tough upstairs setup for TSM to break.
Yeah, very interesting here. We saw a couple of combos going back and forth with the Rooney yesterday. This time they're not going to be bringing the castle barricades like we saw with, I believe it was DZ on Cafe, where they set up the top stairs bathroom like that with the castle barricade that Rooney set up. But this time they're just going to be using the soft barricades, but that's also just going to limit all the throwables that could possibly come in and dislodge any of the members upstairs, especially in the break room area. So either way, Disrupt are set up for this top hold, and they're going to attempt to hold on to this for as long as possible. You can see Merc's already ready for the break room door and for anyone to possibly move just a little bit too far forward. And just remember how much damage that gun does, and if he comes within even a hair of that angle, Merc is more than likely going to kill him. Oh, this is gonna be so close. Oh,
so
my God.
Careful. I believe that mirror window's broken also, so the player on the other side of it can potentially peek into this as well if J9O wants to have a piece of this. For now, it's all on Mark to try to play out from this current position. What's up?
TSM's going to collapse the top floor.
And there we go. There's the start of it. Merc with an initial pick. That's going to take out Mark, who was playing by the mirror window a few seconds ago. Janino lined up for a trade against one of the players on Repel. Doesn't seem to have the exact info. And even worse, now he's been droned out there. So trying to pre-fire to where he thinks the Repel's coming from, but he's got the wrong read on it. Even worse, Merc's still causing problems from the copy window there. Iconic finally going to get a trade against Bolo as he's able to make effort here from the Visa stairs, falling back down to the basement after picking that one up, because they do need to try to play it out for time to a certain extent here. Now that they're down to a 3v4, make that a 2v4. As Merc strikes yet again, single-handedly knocking down the Disrupt roster to just their basement hold now.
Merc is just so unbelievably strong right now on all these angles that he's been able to procure. That's going to be 3-1 favor of TSM as they only lose Bolo there. Bolo, very unlucky so far this season, and that's going to seemingly continue as he starts off 0-0-2, but he's still assisting his team through other means. Shuttle with a really good read on the situation from down low, given that he's got the cardiac sensor here on Pulse. We haven't seen him too much inside of this game just yet, but he's definitely going to play a pivotal role here inside of this low time, especially if Iconic's able to hold on to things. But that's looking to change almost immediately as Chala lights up Iconic. He'll have to translate that into a rotate downstairs. Shuttle trying to get something going here inside of sight, but he's not gonna be able to find it in time. Does he deal the damage to Geo? He does, but it's not enough to kill him. He has to get that cardiac sensor back out. Iconic dies on the rotate. Merc with a quad here as TSM might try and get him the ace.
Shuttle's still going to try to survive as best as he can and kind of play for stats at this point. He's been completely surrounded in a 1v4, but as you can tell, not much he's going to be able to do in that situation. Way too much pressure, broiling way too much quickly against him. So Achieve will get the final frag, and TSM will get the immediate response there, picking up a 1-1 on the overall scoreboard.
That was just an extremely, extremely difficult situation for Disrupt to handle with zero intel on what was going on upstairs. TSM clear out that entire top floor, and then they just simply set up two of their members on Repel, one for copy and one for the actual admin office. Then push over from console with Ash on Achieved, as well as Bolo on the Zofia, and they simply just collapsed right on top of them. They really didn't even need to do that. That was the funniest part about it, is that Merc picked up both frags through the exact same angle. One through the mirror window, obviously, but the other one being Merc trying to push back out of that break room area. So TSM just handling that clear extremely, extremely well. Disrupt not able to battle back, despite Iconic's valiant effort.
So we are going to see the first floor deployment come out now here from Disrupt as they'll start to begin setting up that bunker that we didn't see in the first round and unfortunately led to a premature death of one member of Disrupt. They're trying to survive after falling back down from the upstairs hold. Now an upstairs hold will absolutely still be a thing inside of this round due to, of course, them being directly over the site. There'll be extra emphasis on projector where we're seeing those reinforcements go down now, as well as console directly to the west of the current room we're looking at there. We'll have to see once again how long Disrupt were able to bait out time for TSM. TSM, as Stokes had mentioned, was able to deal with the upstairs play, specifically in admin, really quickly on the last round there. It just took them a couple moments of droning things out, and after that first 30 seconds to a minute had passed by, we're able to execute the players, especially inside of the copier closet there, with relative ease. So we'll see if they can repeat that same feat once again here.
Yeah, I'm really happy that Jesse pointed that out on the desk as well, because I feel like a lot of people, when they look at Siege, are like, oh yeah, the drones are important, right? But how truly important are they? Well, actually, they're more than likely the most important utility you have at your disposal on the offense. And you can see that by what TSM did there. They get the first pick, but they don't just all swing in the windows like you would in a ranked game. No, they redrone the whole area, they get more intel, and then immediately after that, they get another kill. It's constant info being fed back, because at the end of the day, folks, info's only good for about 5 to 10 seconds, to be honest with you. Like, that's the, and past that, the people have legs, they can run wherever they want to. So like, it presents a lot of issues when, you know, 30 seconds later you're like, oh man, you said Mozzie was in console office, now he's bottom yellow. Yeah, well, of course, like, it's come like, on
dude, the dude has a keyboard, he can move. Like,
I don't know if you know this, but there's another human being on the other team and he also has the same,
like,
things that
can,
we do.
He can play, he can move just like you can, like, just because he's on,
yeah, like we're playing against Sister Mary's School for the Blind or something.
He's
like
on doesn't mean he's gonna just sit there all around. Unless it's Mark, of course, who is going to hold this position until he dies, more than likely. He's got some support coming in from J9O here, but with the Repel setup on the window, there is no clear path for him to get outside of this position, and more than likely have to play it out. The Nitro is there, but the immediate re-repel back up to the roof is going to make that Nitro cell, unfortunately, not find the impact he wanted to find. Look at that play from Mark, though. Certainly thriving under the worst of conditions. Still able to line up a banger of a headshot before he ends up going down. That's probably the most influential player we've seen so far on TSM getting knocked out in that situation as well. So if he was going to pick any target to take out right there in a one-for-one trade, he'd definitely pick the right one.
Well, if you're going to go out, you might as well go out with a bang, you know what I mean? So this completely makes sense. Mark's in a pretty poor position there. Nitro Cell already burnt. He's low HP. Might as well swing and see if he can possibly get something. And it pays off, taking down Merc, who we've already seen be such a difficult person to try and get around for Disrupt. And this is starting to link together for DG. Retro with another pick on T'Challa. Another player that has just been so strong for TSM off the board. Is TSM now in the dying moments of round three as they're trying to find some more offense, but Disrupt shutting it down at the door. J9 with a double kill, leaving Achieved all in his lonesome.
Honestly, I think Mark's death set up absolute victory here for Disrupt, because before Mark went down, he got info on almost the exact positions of like two to three other players here. Good pickup from Achieved at least to start turning this around, but keep in mind he's alone here. And that info, I think, allowed Disrupt to get a lot more aggressive and really play into some of these positions against the TSM attack. So Achieved still trying to play this out. About to run out of time in a moment here, so he's going to get pushed kind of crazily by Retro as we get a funny end of that round. But Disrupt taken, not much of a surprise seeing how the hold went after the projector play.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that Mark was definitely like the martyr for that situation. Like, that was the play that was a necessity. And after that, Disrupt just had everything at their disposal they needed to be able to shut down the push from TSM into Projector as well as Flag. We didn't see so much Flag pressure, but definitely Projector being a hot spot for TSM that they were not able to get around, especially with J9's presence upstairs inside of front desk. So either way, that's going to push Disrupt back downstairs after they're able to pick up their second defensive round. So far, only losing on the split side.
Continue to trade back and forth. As Stokes mentioned, only a loss on the split site, and this was a pretty confident win for the members of Disrupt back in round number one as well. Some initial success was found by TSM, specifically with the speed. They were able to clear out the second floor hold from Disrupt here, but had a lot of problems working their way into the actual basement, as usual with a lot of teams, kind of just due to a lack of time overall after they spent quite a bit trying to establish those top downs. We're going to see a little bit more emphasis on that this time, most notably because Merc is now bringing himself onto the sledge instead of the Amaru as we were seeing previously. So immediately we've got a lot more access to soft destruction here. Should be a lot easier to play from Piano, specifically while the team is trying to take control of the site as well as in post plant, as I think they might have had a slight issue with that in the previous round though against this site. 10 seconds
remaining. Yeah, going back to that basement defense, that did seem to be the issue when it came down to it. Just not enough soft destruction. I mean, they did have Achieve live through a lot of the initial brunt of Disrupt's utility, almost dying there. If you guys remember that play with Mark getting locked up inside a bathroom, but TSM eventually dealt with it. They just weren't able to get the plant down downstairs because of timing, basically. Disrupt were able to lock them out and then use the rest of their utility as well as those crossfires, just being extremely detrimental to TSM's push. So this time around, more than likely looking to get down to Piano in a more timely fashion, as well as looking for this initial pick. Disrupt are going to be on an extended hold here, actually still having Retro all the way upstairs inside a Projector. Mark going to be playing grass for the time being. This could honestly be a pretty good hold from them. Just a 1-1-3 going on across the entirety of Consulate.
Holdo going to commit himself to the inside here. No immediate pressure working itself against him, but he is still going to have to eventually deal with Retro, currently sitting on the inside of Projector here. Now, he's ready for that play. Mark also going to rotate up here, because as far as Disrupt know, it's only one player that's moved to the inside of Admin, although, of course, they'll expect more. Retro going to decide to give up that position ultimately, though. A minute has now gone from the clock, and Disrupt is happy with that amount of time being wasted, and TSM only just now starting to take second floor control, so they're going to start to pull back here, and TSM will have free reign to continue investigating this for the next minute or so before they're also going to be forced into condensing down into the basement.
Once again, a solid roam game here from Disrupt that gets everyone out alive. This is something you can't say for every single Consulate team, so to have this happen two times in a row is definitely quite the successful play. Breaching charge down doesn't get rid of the Nitro Cell, so Mark's going to wait for somebody to come and try and play the angle, and once they do, well, they'll see the magic trick that he has for them underneath the floorboards. Mark backing off now, though, as there's too many angles getting opened up. That breaching charge might eat up that Nitro, so we'll have to see a little bit later on, but as of right now, TSM working everything they possibly can utility-wise. Garage panels going down, as well as the verticality and Piano being stripped down to the bars to make sure no one can play around Van.
Nitro was detonated in the process of that wall being opened up by the Selmas. As you can see from the health pulls, though, no significant impact in the damage department coming out from Disrupt there. Once again, the TSM are going to find themselves relatively soon at a lack for time. However, at least on this round, they do have more opportunities opened up, more importantly, more angles to play off of, as you can see specifically with Achieved right now. Having the cutoff to the inside of Cafeteria to make sure they can't immediately get pelted down by an Alda the second they try to push this. Now, there's still going to be resistance from J9O and at least one other player, I believe, from the inside of Security here. It was also an issue back on round one, but here we go. Smoke's coming out from both sides. It's the gas from the defense and the vision obscuring ones from the attack.
Uh-oh.
Doesn't seem to hold them back though, as Geo sneaks in. Bolo gets another entry here also, and it's a clean plant from TSM. That's a big problem from Disrupt. They don't have great intel about the post plant positioning for TSM, and even worse, they're all stuck to the outside. There you go. Geo sneaks in one more kill before being traded out on a Nitro Iconic on a bit of a tear here, as he gets the Nitro kill and one more on the outside of the garage panels as well. Retro already working on the counter defuse, and he might just get it here. Merc's the last player standing. They do jump off of that, as Achieved is still in this fight also. He kills the first player trying to do it. Great play on the audio cue there from Merc. Catches J9O mid-reload. That's going to force Iconic off of the counter defuse. Wouldn't have even had time to get back to it now, but regardless, Merc comes in from yellow to shut out the round as TSM take it, and these teams continue to trade rounds back and forth.
Fantastic clear from TSM and in an even better plant. They're able to get around Disrupt's utility play, which we saw be quite successful, at least stunting them at the door, but they progressed past that. That was the biggest deal there. Able to get rid of the Banshees that were plaguing them inside of Garage and actually get a more offset plant, one could say, near the back at the actual bomb chassis. And that's just such a smart area to play, especially because Disrupt didn't play for any intel there. As you guys remember, Maestro's banned right now, so they don't have anything that's currently covering the floor and is able to see through smokes and stuff like that. The only insight that they have to what's going on at the garage panel is the mirror windows and anyone that wants to riskily peek out of security hallway. So it makes it a very big issue, especially when that utility comes in from Geo, the smokes blocking away that vision, because now they're just shooting blind. They're throwing utility everywhere, trying to see if they can possibly get a kill, and none of it lands on where Geo's true location is.
So a reattempt rolling in here from Disrupt, as they were, to be fair, relatively close to retaking that, only faltering again due to the increased top-down pressure that came from Achieved, as well as the other members of TSM. Some trouble controlling Yellow there too, due to the great play coming out from Merc. So once again, I mean, really props to the individuals on TSM for playing their post play pretty much perfectly there, especially Merc from outside the Yellow door. The catch on the mid reload against J9O, very, very well done from him to ensure victory. But before that point, when we were down in what I believe was a 2v3 up until that point, it was looking very likely Disrupt were going to be able to get themselves that counter defuse going. Thankfully, Achieved saves the day, reignites the potential for Merc, and allows them to close out. So let's see if Disrupt can patch up those issues, make sure the post plant isn't established so cleanly by TSM this time, and hopefully allows Disrupt to get back out and work on that counter defuse a bit more quickly, or just outright prevent it as they've done in previous rounds.
Yeah, this has been pretty hotly contested so far, but it's mostly been Achieved in Merc battling up against Iconic. J9 obviously sprinkling some plays in there as well, but it's not as spread across the scoreboard as of right now as we sit 2-2. So progressing later on, obviously, we want to see a lot of these players from both squads start to find their groove, and that could all spark off right now. Two more rounds of defense here for Disrupt, so they should start feeling a little bit more comfortable, or at least Mark, as he's in a much better position given the circumstances of where he was in Projector the last time. Merc going to make some solid progress up Yellow. Lights down Retro to a singular HP, practically, given this L85, but Merc still has to worry about console, as we did see Mark in there before.
Mark trying to stay quiet here, not revealing himself, hoping that we see an overcommitment for Merc to finish off Retro, as he more than likely knows he's got some significant damage onto it. There we go. It's not against the player we expected to pick up here, however, though. It is going to be Bolo that gets dropped by Mark instead. Achieved, able to trade, but again, Disrupt so quick on the counters here. Iconic, an immediate Nitro Cell again from him to make sure that Disrupt stays in an advantageous position, only losing one player out of that fight and bringing it down to a 4v3.
All right, well, slow moving right now for TSM, as they've lost two of their members, so you can't exactly blame them. Some default cams up, still giving intel to Disrupt as well as to how this top clear is going. They've delayed so much time here and been able to reposition. Iconic with another kill inside of this round, as he's still allowed to be alive, currently at the bottom of admin stairs, awaiting the push from TSM as they begin breaking up the floor inside of Piano, just trying to get some more angles down low. Both of these attacks seemingly pretty solid when it came to this portion, but the execute is where things went awry. Let's see if TSM can patch things up once again here to get their second successful.
No.
Oh, Merc.
That was close.
Oh man, that's a all right.
Merc doesn't even want to throw the second nade now. He's like, I think I got the angle on this one, so he's just gonna shoot it out instead. Probably a smart call, considering how unlucky things almost went for him right there. Either way, though, down to 30 seconds. TSM now need to make the commitment while a player down, and once again, Shuttle still causing problems. In fact, has the smart glasses ready to counter out the flashes that are being chucked to the inside here. Also a great capability for him to be able to see through those smokes and potentially deny. You can see it. He's caught the player going down to the corner. Gas gonna deny it, and Shuttle finishes it off. Geo goes down with the case. Iconic finds a second. We're down to only Merc here in a 1v4. He's got no right to reinitiate, but he finds the way in anyway. Iconic goes down, but it'll be dropped by J9O before he can get past the garage threshold. Another round for Disrupt. The trade spree continues between these two teams.
Well, Disrupt's getting away with another garage defense here. Extremely solid stuff, especially since, you know, Consulate's garage, not the best site when it comes down to it. Actually, the worst win rate out of all of the sites that we see normally played here. 45% for garage, 56% for lobby, and 50% currently for Teller's Archives. So either way, Well, what we expected. TSM are able to get map control and actually control the vertical angles as well as get the garage open, but they're not able to translate that into a successful execute. And that was most notably to obviously disrupt six pick onto the Warden. They weren't accounting for them to try and have an ace up their sleeve that they hadn't used throughout the round. Because if you guys noticed, Shuttle didn't really shoot at anybody or try and make his presence known, because you don't want them to know that you have something that can literally see through their main game plan. So obviously, very well done from Disrupt, not only on delaying the time, but also forcing it down to the wire to put TSM in that position.
But the great thing that we've been seeing evolve itself into the meta is that Warden play. That's happening due to the increased prevalence of smokes that we've also started to see at the beginning of this season. A lot of variety, which is always great to see as more and more teams are making those slight adjustments to add that bit of personality to their squads and, of course, keep the meta as varied as it has been inside of the stage.
Okay, well, lobby defense for Disrupt on their very last defensive half of the entirety of stage one. Obviously, if we go to OT, that could change up, but we'll have to see what happens first. Don't want to get too ahead of ourselves. Don't count our eggs, or don't count our chickens before they hatch, you know what I mean? So it looks like Disrupt will be holding things down upstairs once again. Mark going to be in a very familiar and dangerous position like we saw him the last time when he was able to secure the kill onto Merc.
I've heard anybody wondering about these standards.
Oh, what?
What's up?
Iconic is dead, almost.
How did that happen? I was alt-tab. I was actually
he got shot from front lobby, I think. there's an angle that you can hold from, like, the front lobby, like, stairs that lead up to the main door. If you crouch down to the right-hand side, you can see under the main door, and I think he got shot from that. That's, like, a really, really, like, traditional spot.
Ooh. Awkward moment here for Paulo as he tries to use the breaching charge, but clearly someone else has already dealt with it for him. But either way, gain nothing lost. More specifically, out of that scenario. Iconic still going to be alive despite the damage he took earlier on in the round, and TSM continuing to go about their business as normal. The big question here inside of this round is whether TSM can complete that trade spree and fully go back and forth, a true seesaw all the way through this half, or if Disrupt is finally going to be able to solidify things at the end of the half with their own repeated victory, which would be the first time a team has won, I believe anyway, more than one single round inside of this match.
Well, can Disrupt get it done? It starts off with a slow clear here from TSM, but we've seen how strong they are with this clear and their ability to get information off of these drones. An assistant with Merc as well, with that Inox scanner, so we'll see if he can possibly get any insight that could assist them in clearing out this top level. J9 currently playing inside of Connector. Obviously, we saw Retro holding things down in front desk and playing for the long hallway, but this is the main thing going on right now for DG. They've actually got Shuttle all the way downstairs, playing the strongest role in Pulse Can on this map, that bottom floor, as you can actually read every single position for anyone inside of the top floor on the offense. So Disrupt having a lot of info coming into this last minute.
Mark gonna have a lot of problems here soon, but he's already faced off against this once and has been able to guarantee at least a one-for-one exchange. His teammates coming in to assist as well. Shuttle gonna be able to pick up one, although no trade this time for Mark. It's achieved instead that cuts his head off before he even gets a chance to think about his positioning there. Very nicely done. That will open up access to Projector for the attack, but how much time does it leave them to focus on the site? His Projector is just a side objective here. They need to get into the site, and they only have 35 seconds to do it, and this is while there's still pressure from J9O and Retro on the second floor.
Yeah, this is insanity right now for TSM, as this is going to be a low time execute with very minimal space control, especially for the top floor, as Disrupt should be able to resurge into Projector and prevent any plant attempt. Iconic with a great move here, gets around the drone game, should hear the plant start for Geo as Retro moves to the top hatch. He'll take down one, or that's actually going to be J9. Nitro gets stuck. J9 with another one. Retro actually flanks up into grass, takes down Bolo inside of that area, and then Iconic with the dagger to the heart to this TSM roster, able to claim round four and make this a 4-2 split.
Iconic and Retro making the difference there towards the end. Unfortunately, Iconic, I believe, stuck on the inside of the bathroom, so unable to contribute as much as he would have liked that, but some of the other players able to rotate around to the back of Circle Desk, the bottom of the spiral stairs there, and make the necessary impact that we needed to see out of our defensive team. So Disrupt finally breaking that streak, able to win a second round there, solidifies an advantage coming out of the first half at 4-2. Now, of course, they jump onto the attack. TSM takes the defense, and we're going to a familiar sight as TSM is going to attempt, for the first time here on their own half, the basement hold. They're going to bring Echo into the play, but never mind. Man, it's always when I mention these operators, they get six picked. Just over towards a mute for Bolo instead. So overall, nothing crazy going to come out of the lineup here.
Yeah, they just really don't want you to have fun. You know what I mean?
No.
So, but the thing is, for TSM,
that,
right?
For that removal, actually, won't get baited by players anymore.
Yeah. The six pick phase, something that we're probably not going to be seeing for too much longer. But hey, we don't know when or what is going to happen with that. So, either way, though. As we do end up hitting the split here, guys, remember, this match actually has a lot of things to do with how these standings are stacking up. TSM currently in fourth place at 12 points, with Mirage just ahead of them in third with 14. So that's mean if they, that means if they can close this out inside of regulation, they actually shoot past Mirage with three more points to be 15th, tie up the Sonics in second place as well. And hey, that's something you might want. You know, it's a pretty big difference in money as well.
Should be noted that they will default to third place, though. They will,
because they lost to the Sonic,
they
right?
They do not have the capability to take the second place mantle. They would actually, I believe, in some circum, if they take an OT win here, I think they tie with Mirage, but they will still end up beating Mirage in a tie point scenario, because TSM did beat Mirage in their head-to-head matchup. The first condition we used to settle those ties. Merc nearly finding a lineup here with some aggression on the second floor yellow staircase, but not going to be able to translate it. Retro's curious, though. He's going to come back to take another peek at this.
Oh, Merc. This is getting somewhat scary for some reason, even though this is only 40 seconds into round 7. But looks like that's going to subside, though, as Retro is going to move on from that situation. You can't exactly blame him either. He is the hard destruction here. Obviously, they do have J9 as well. Actually, two hard destructors coming along for the ride. So J9 probably going to have less of a leash on him, and he'll probably be able to do things a little bit more freely. But especially for this top floor attack, this will assist them if they're able to get him into the copier area. They'll be able to have some sort of hard breach onto projector if there are any reinforcements there. But as for TSM, this looks to be kind of just like crosses set up to assist each other. Bolo's got really good info in this area. He's playing on top of a Mute Jammer, so they can't drone him out. Just going to play the close angle with the M590, and anyone that steps up to the plate, more than likely getting sauced.
Chief still waiting for this pressure to begin to broil out against him over by the Visa stairs. He knows they're going to have to take it eventually. He's relying on support from Bolo as well across the hallway here. The aggression pans out specifically for Merc, the player we're not even watching right now, actually. He's on the other side of the map towards yellow. Go full to our observer. Of course, we had a near fight building up there. Merc will translate that, though, as he takes down Achieved and brings us into a 4v4 now. Both teams just take one player away from either side of the map, and it seems the aggression, at least for Disrupt, is going to go into a calming moment here. TSM also backing their remaining roam game out, back down towards the actual site.
And this would be a big deal here if Retro was the only hard breach, but luckily enough for Disrupt, that is not the case. Obviously, as we talked about J9 prior on the ace, so they'll still have the ability to get the garage door popped open, as well as some really good info as to what's going on site. Shuttle's still getting some pings on a location, so they'll be able to account for at least one TSM member, but 45 seconds remain, and they haven't even started breaking up the floor inside of Piano, so this is going to get down to an extremely low amount of time, as well as TSM still having plenty of utility to battle back off of site.
Geo waiting for the timing here. Has the Nitro Cell Prime, but he's got to be cautious playing from this position by white. The good news is that there's laser gates blocking off what I believe is going to be the majority of the garage, specifically the left side towards the white van where Geo was playing until a second ago. So he does have some security, and he's got a headshot too now, locking in on Iconic to take him down and reasserting the advantage for TSM. This is a major loss too, as we're coming down to the wire. They're going to push their way in. Gas charges go out to try and stop J9O, but no, it's actually Merc that takes that kill and not J9O there. He's going to pick one up. They're going to continue to move in here. The plant down on the ground. Geo denies it as there's a mad rush to take out J9O. TSM succeeds in that task and wins out the round on the timer.
Well, very nice way to start off their defensive half. TSM with a solid hold upstairs as they're able to get away with it as well successfully. Disrupt not finding as many picks as they necessarily wanted, as well as not being able to procure a plant spot in the actual site. That's going to force Disrupt into a pretty bad situation where they're not able to actually overwatch their planter. They're going to end up losing because of that. TSM, great defense down low, especially with the ability to contest those angles from above from Geo.
Might have a pause or a rehost come in here, as there seems to be an issue with the six-pick mechanic for TSM. So yeah, that's getting called for now. I believe we are going to go to that real quickly here, as we do need to pull off a rehost or a reconnection at a minimum for one of these players in order to accomplish that. Apologies for the delay, folks. This obviously has sped up a little bit recently due to the implementation of a pause feature. It looks like we're going to try to just reconnect the player having that issue real quick. And if that doesn't work, I believe we'll try a full-on rehost.
Okay, well, the funny thing about this is it's Bolo that disconnects it. Okay. It's going to be the pole.
It worked, so we can start the game in a second.
Yeah, yeah, that's actually really, really nice. But the thing I wanted to point out here is they're going to bring the Alibi. And that's actually really, really solid for this site in general. Alibi is an operator that we don't talk about all that often, just because she is kind of a meme pick in a certain sense. You know, she has hollows. There's a lot of outplayability when it comes down to it, because obviously Alibi looks exactly like her clones. So you can stand inside of your clones and do like cool plays like that. But that's not really what she's used for inside of competitive play. She's used for areas in which you're going to see a lot of pre-firing go on. Kind of like the lobby site in general. You're going to see a lot of these windows just get shot immediately, and Shala more than likely going to have some prismas around that area, or really anywhere where a lot of gunfire is going to be, you know, going down.
It's much less so recently, but I believe there's also like a small comfortability factor as well. Her kit seems to be pretty well preferred among certain players that like her playstyle. So I think it's the MX4 Storm, I think, is that gun that people tend to like quite a bit.
It's a pretty solid SMG, yeah. To be fair.
Like I said, it's less of the reason why she gets picked nowadays, I think, just because we barely see her picked anymore. But yeah, I think at least part of the reason why some teams would like to go to her is just for that comfortability factor. It's a very easy gun to work with.
I feel like I would totally play her more if her prismas had any of her skins. I think that's the only thing that kind of holds me back from playing Alibi. I don't want the defaults, though. I have, like, really cool Alibi skins.
Got something against the original character design of Alibi?
No, absolutely not. But when I have skins that I've paid money for, I want to be able to use them.
Well,
that's all. I just like my skins.
Who made the mistake there?
You're completely right. I've spent way too much money on this game in my life. I don't even want that conversation.
Who spent money on skins that make the mechanic kind of a moot point.
But I look really cool when I kill people, though. So, like, you know, it's fine.
You just feel extra dominant because it's like, haha, not only did you get tricked by my clone, I wasn't even looking like it.
The best part is when somebody will pull off, like, a Prisma play and they have, like, the highlighter pink gun skin on, like, Plasma Pink. And it's like, oh, dude, he was playing inside of his Prisma.
We need something like the Mozzie Cheesehead skin or the Pizza Head skin for her, just so, like, we can really accentuate that point.
Oh, man.
Getting back to the action, though, here is obviously we're just in that first minute or so of the round. Disrupt not playing into this too aggressively, so we're not going to see a whole lot of action going on here. Just Disrupt trying to gather drone intel and find the safest path into the map itself here. As we've already seen, they've made significant progress on taking control of the basement, but obviously we're not attacking the basement, so a little bit more work needing to be done here by Disrupt.
No, it's a solid idea from Disrupt to clear out down low, though, because they need to worry about the Nitro Cell potential from TSN, but they're not going to be holding on to that. Instead, currently, they're playing for Z with Achieved on a bottom spiral here, waiting for any rotate from downstairs, so they're trying to shut off any avenues from them gaining control of Garage down low, as TSM mostly harbored around mid-floor as well as that top floor in the projector area, just trying to play these angles. Although Disrupt will be able to clear out a decent amount of utility from down here just with some sight intel coming in from the drones, but this looks to be a pretty harsh execute, especially given that Shuttle is indeed on Lion.
I'm going to wrap back up here. Spots the mirror window, so just popping that real quick. Not that any play could really come from that at this point anyway inside of the round, but either way, just making sure. Coming down to the wire here, and this is probably the least action-y round. Terrible adjective, but this is probably the least action we've had inside of a round so far in this matchup here. Still at a full 5v5. Of course, I jinx it when I bring it up, as Mark's going to be able to pick up that first kill. But we're getting to that point in the round where teams have to get aggressive here. And thankfully for Disrupt, it started out well for them. Iconic with a slow lurk, going to be able to take out two players from his position at yellow as well. Achieved changes up the fate for TSM, but only slightly, as he's only able to get that single trade. And now he's locked in the 1v4, trying his best to abuse the post plants that may be right outside of the front door. Can't find any of those, so he's got to go for the window plane. This is the most brutal one he has yet. Nitro up top. There's no one there, though. It just opens up another angle, and eventually it's going to be the drive-by from Retro to take down Achieved. And, of course, give Disrupt the round.
And here it comes, the timeout from TSM. And everyone might be wondering, like, why? That's only the fifth round. Well, actually, this round right here has massive implications. TSM can no longer lose any rounds. Disrupt currently sits at 5. They're on the door of match point, and if they are able to actually win this next round, TSM can no longer get all 3 points necessary to surpass third place, being Mirage.
Yep, that is going to be the major issue for them. They can, it should be noted, still potentially tie Mirage's point totals, though, since the difference between those two teams is 12 to 14. So if TSM ends up winning in overtime, they'll still tie Mirage's point totals overall, and I believe they'll still pass them due to the head-to-head advantage TSM will have. So chances for third place not going to be completely dead just as of yet here. But still, it's starting to look a bit drastic for TSM. And it's important to note, too, that obviously Disrupt has the capability to pass TSM themselves. Not only that, but also Dark Zero and Space Station Gaming if they win this matchup, because Disrupt would then go from 10 to 13 points, and that would leave TSM in 5th, Dark Zero in 6th, and Space Station down in 7th.
Mm-hmm. And just to confirm that, by the way, I just grabbed the stats for us as well. TSM did indeed beat Mirage 7-3 on April 6th. So that will be TSM taking third place away if they're able to win this in OT as well. But still, those points do matter quite a bit.
Certainly the case. Disrupt, which should be noted as well, do need to beat TSM in regulation. If it goes to an overtime victory, TSM still gets that default 1 point by making it to overtime. And that will be enough of a difference to where they cannot be passed by Disrupt. So they will have the secured fourth place, but then they will not be able to pass Mirage. That would only leave them 1 point behind Mirage's overall total. Hopefully you got all that. If not, just go ahead and check out the Liquipedia article. That'll probably allow you to break it down for yourself quite easily.
Yeah, when it comes to talking format and what can happen with teams and points and stuff like that, it can
pretty quickly here.
Yeah.
For anybody that's confused but is curious about the potential changeups to the standings that'll happen after this game, just go ahead and take a peek at the Liquipedia page. It gives a lot of great info, and it's the same thing I've been looking at this entire time. So your guess will be as good as mine in that situation.
I was gonna say, hey, you can't give away all the caster secrets. Come on, you know.
Yeah, thankfully
we totally don't stare at Liquipedia all day.
Thankfully we're at home. We have computers that we can actually use here. we're not fiddling around on iPads like we normally do. So we can.
No, that's
can
that's like usually that the problem.
That's one of the benefits of homecasting. But either way, getting into the action here on the outset of this round, TSM once more, I believe, going for the split site defense this time. So we'll see how that strategy is going to pan out for them as they try to get something on the board inside of this half and continue to try and come back against Disrupt, who are looking strong here on the outset of their attack, and of course look to continue that. We got an interesting wrinkle already being built up on this round, though, achieved with a lot of info, but is not expecting such an aggressive play. He gets chased out of that staircase incredibly quickly and now has to try and fight for survival here as he more than likely attempts to back up towards Spiral.
Well, TSM continuing to use a plethora of different operators, actually using eight different operators, 8 to 10. Let's see. 10 different operators in their defensive lineups, which is something that's pretty impressive when it comes down to it. We don't see a lot of teams really expand their horizons that wide when it comes down to different utility pieces that they can possibly get something out of. But TSM seemingly making it work extremely well, taking down J9 early on. But just remember, Disrupt still running the double hard breach. They have Habana here that could definitely be the saving grace later on.
Iconic hunting for any heads that may be presented to him on the first floor there by continuing to go back and forth on the rappel. Nothing being spotted out just yet. They're going to figure out that the Vigil is somewhere nearby. Of course, won't get the exact info, but they will know that it's inside of copy room now due to the fact that the drone is shot from the inside of there. Where exactly, though, that much info has not been presented as of yet due to the use of the ERC. Got a good angle onto Mark, and Mark tries to recross after the first peek there. Has to go back into coverage. Once again, we'll try to dodge the drone with the ERC. A little bit more difficult now here because Iconic is joining this fight from the other side. The double swing, but Merc still holding for two. Let's
no
make it
way.
Three as well as he takes down Shuttle. Ultimately, finally falling to Retro on the rappel outside, but that's totally a worthy trade. The damage is done. He will be able to get Merc back up. So at a minimum, we will still have two alive here for Disrupt. But now it's a 2v4, and Merc is not in great shape to gunfight here. He's only got 20 HP left.
Yeah, well, Disrupt now in pretty bad standings here. TSM, well, specifically Merc, just way too powerful inside of round 9, and DG don't handle it all too well. Just seemingly swinging him one by one as Merc is able to knock off heads left and right. But now Disrupt trying to find a plant here inside of Tellers. As said previously, it's down to Merc and Retro, but make that just Retro as Bolo removes the noggin from Merc as well. Retro trying to push down Spiral. Bolo will handle that situation with flying colors. TSM, round 9 in the bag as they're trying to shore up this gap.
We said TSM a lot on the line for this matchup. They're also looking for a boost in the standings, the prize pool, and the SI points they'll get out of this stage. So it means just as much to them as it does to Disrupt here, as both teams are very hungry for the win. Very unfortunate outset there for Disrupt. A good start to the round as they're able to get that second floor control quite handily, but unable to deal with Merc wreaking havoc from the inside of the copy closet there, shutting down three players, and I believe downing a fourth as well, before ultimately being taken down on a trade from the last remaining players still standing there for Disrupt. Not really much they can do from the 2v4, considering they have to fully press against the basement play, where I believe all Nitro cells were still going to be active for those players, so they couldn't have gone for a first floor plant. There would have been a very easy pinch against them as well, should the Nitro cells have failed. Just no winning combo really being lined up in my headcanon there for Disrupt from the 2v4, unfortunately.
Yeah, no, not at all. And this is just showing how potent Disrupt is when it comes to Consulate. I mean, even looking at their win rates per side, like, they have a 64% win rate on their offensive rounds, as well as a 65% defensive win rate. So, I mean, that's pretty crazy when you compare that to TSM on defense with a 44.4% and their offense being 50%. So, Disrupt, definitely one of their favorite maps when it comes down to it. And then you can see exactly why they have this lead right now. That last round, though, definitely a big difference maker when it came to TSM. So we'll have to see if they can continue on with things like this, but more than likely not in the same fashion, as Merc just went nuclear right there.
Merc, a massive resurgence from him in this last play week here, as he's had a pretty quiet season up until these past couple of weeks of play, where we started to see him shine out a lot more, and it's certainly making the difference, at least in that previous round. Gonna see pressure already applied to Achieved here, as he's gonna have some unfortunate time. He nearly walking into the spray as that bottom Visa stairs window gonna get cleared out by one of the initial players on Disrupt. We're just poking a hole in it than anything there, so nothing that Achieved has to worry about for a long time, but he'll slightly get in his way. Aside from that though, Disrupt still focusing pretty heavily on the drone game for the first minute or so of the round. Bolo around the corner might have just gotten spotted out. Gonna have to be careful here now, as there we go. Lasergate gonna get taken care of via Nade getting chucked in here. Bolo ready to play against it anyway. EE1D gonna lock him in place for a couple of seconds, as Iconic is also committing to the clear. Same for J9O inside of Admin.
It's all clear so far from Disrupt, but they still have quite a few facets of this defense to worry about from TSM, especially Bolo up top currently playing Soda. Swinging a copy at any moment in time, but more than likely not going to be the play, as Achieved and him are set up in very similar fashion to what we saw the last time, just controlling these two lanes. Also a drone down low for Disrupt. They actually know exactly where Achieved is right now. You can see the hot pings, and that right there is why hot pings are so unbelievably dangerous. They just slice the staircase up to where Achieved has zero breathing room, try and force him down low, already have the hatch popped, and deal with him accordingly. Great stuff from DG as Iconic picks up the frag.
Bolo still waiting for this pressure to barrel towards him. Does hear the Banshee and even gets across, but is unable to make the damage against Iconic, who is the player to swing that there. That will force him back, as that Banshee was his one safety net to play inside of Vending. Doesn't have the early warning of the swing anymore, and more importantly, can very easily be pinched out if he continued to stay in that spot. He'll fall back to Projector instead to continue baiting out time, which, to be fair, he's done a pretty good job of that just by having presence on the inside of the second floor. It stopped Disrupt from focusing on the actual site take. No longer, though, as Merc finds the cross angle and catches Bolo trying to drop down hatch.
Yeah, Bolo assuming that it was going to be the upside down rappel, but that was definitely not the case. TSM, now worse for wear going in these last 45 seconds, but that's the good news. The timer, extremely low for DG, but we've seen them try to pull this off before. Did not get that plant attempt down in the best of fashions, but right now Iconic processing through all of the things he must do so very quickly. Oh. But oh my god, Merc dusted inside of the bathroom. What a refrag from Iconic. Was not expecting that one, but that's going to change up the entire game plan for TSM. They're down to only two members. Geo taking a lot of heat. He's trying to push forward onto White Van, playing an off angle. Pops in Nitro as Chala's continuing to smoke things down. This Vector trying to deal damage at range, but he can't even hit his target. Geo goes prone instead. As you can see, they've moved in. The hot ping on the planter. He's trying to get it done, but Merc hits the deck, shoots him in the face. Chala's able to get one for himself, but the plant's locked up. Disrupt, are they able to at least force overtime? Mark's been down. Chala with big play so far. He'll light up Retro as well. As we'll actually have Merc be able to continue his life just for a little while longer. I'll have some more info on Shala before he's sent to his demise. But now, fantastic post-plant here for DG, as they will be able to at least hold on to Shala, or Shala will at least be able to find some safe space on an opposite angle here. Nobody currently holding above him inside a piano. One yellow player, one outside. Retro's got the angle locked down on the breach, and it's all said and done. Round 10 for Disrupt, as they guarantee overtime and take a point away from TSM.
Another situation where the fate is sealed, unfortunately, for our final player, although Chala tries his best to make up the difference there, at least mops up the remaining on-site presence, but the post-plant positioning is too strong there. It has to go directly into the angle of one of the remaining Disrupt members in order to clutch that, and just is not ready for the challenge immediately outside. We'll drift into what could very well be the final round of this matchup now. Disrupt leading at 6-4. We'll have to see if they can get the final round needed to close this out coming up right now.
And this has just been such a fantastic showing from Disrupt so far here today. And honestly, we can say that about all of their Consulate games. I think that this is a team that you seriously need to avoid this map when you're playing up against them. Obviously, TSM having their showing on this match as well, or on this map as well, but it hasn't actually been for quite some time. They haven't played this map since January 23rd up against Dark Zero in the US Division 2020 Finals. So it's been a minute. To consider for TSM, but obviously they did have VOD walking into this. This is more than likely why this was the map choice. It just, you know, sometimes the plan doesn't exactly work out in your favor.
All right, guys, so let's focus up here, because this is a very, very big round. The next two are very, very big rounds. Remember what we talked about before with the standings. Disrupt currently in 7th place with 10 points, TSM in 4th with 12. Those of you who know how our points are distributed on wins, you'll know that if Disrupt gets the win right here, they are going to jump from 7th to 4th place and be locked in, as this is the final game of the stage.
On top of that, they're going to put their faith inside of a top hold, a site that I believe we have only seen a singular time this entire stage. Yes, in fact, our last possible round here for stage 1 is on a CEO meeting hold that has a 0% win rate and only one play on the actual site across 3 maps. So, for TSM, this is going to be half of that, and then see if they can actually change up this win rate. The possibility here is Disrupt is out on the field already and starting to work these windows, and this is where this site starts to deteriorate. Once this window control comes in, is if Disrupt is able to start putting pressure onto TSM and forcing them into awkward situations, they could more than likely walk into these crossfires and die to Disrupt handedly. This first minute is about to be off the board as we're starting to get some more insight into how TSM are setting things up. Love what they have going on with Bolo and Achieved, especially upstairs inside a cubby with those ADSs.
To have that first floor hold set up for TSM to try and delay. Now, this will be interesting, as you don't always see this happen on the inside of this site, let alone you don't often see this site get played. So the few times we've gone back to it, we have seen slightly more unique takes from the defenders than previously played, due to the fact that the standard default for this site is considered relatively played out for the most part and generally advantageous towards the attackers in most situations here. Already seeing Disrupt line up some good information, but there's still a lot to deal with. The Aruni gates blocking off both of the access points to console is going to leave only Retro on that angle. More players looking for other paths towards the inside of this. You've got the rappel on the outside balcony. Bolo still downstairs here on the first floor looking to cause trouble with his presence, and he's not the only one, as they have additional players looking to do the same thing. Disrupt is very cautious here. They may not have the full read on what exactly TSM are planning, and you can tell that because they seem very hesitant to actually try to make a play. In fact, look at this, Geo tearing him up. 2 kills so far unresponded to by Disrupt. Oh! A wild swing at Longdesk to take down Iconic on Rappel as well. This is Geo's world, and we're just living in it.
The baby-faced Acer, if he's able to get the last 2 frags. Aww. Here he goes for the flick. Mark finally is able to shut him down, but a hot streak so far from our only Mexican player here. Fantastic stuff from Geo today as he's trying to help his squad survive. Mark and Shuttle, the only 2 that remain. Mark currently on the duly named Suicide Balcony. If he does indeed hop inside that window, Shuttle still on Rappel for Connector here, as TSM can simply sit on their hands and wait out this timer. It has to be a forceful play here from DG, as the achieve just trying to play to his hitbox. And speaking of hitbox, he'll get lit up, but he won't find that headshot. In comes the Suicide Balcony player. Mark's dusted. Shuttle the last one to remain, and Merc will clean that one up as well. TSM staying on top of things in round 11.
A solid hold, and more importantly than that, a confusing one, it seemed, for Disrupt, trying to play to the outskirts of the site for so long, trying to hunt heads and get the initiating kill they needed to start taking some map control away, but they could never really begin to do it. They can't push in through Yellow Door because there's constant presence for at least two players on the inside of Piano. They also can't push Visa side either, let alone Admin, as I believe there's still roaming presence established from TSM in both of those positions also. So Disrupt have to be content with just sitting on the outside repels, hoping they can get a kill, and then trying to go for the sort of all-in initiation through the balcony, as well as the hop-in from console. And I would assume some Yellow Stairs pressure too, but they were just never really able to get it going, mainly because of what we saw from Geo on the middle of all that action by Longdesk.
So the cool news about that last round is that TSM is actually going to effectively double the win success rate of CEO Meeting, which means that CEO Meeting currently has a 50% win rate, which will tie it with the second most winnable site on that map.
Wouldn't it have been a 0% win rate before this? Or?
Yeah.
So they increased it by an infinite percent then.
Yeah, actually, because there was only one round played on it. So
TSM
they're half the sample.
To break the calculator right now.
Oh, my TI-83 can't even handle it, man. We're just
can't divide by zero, so there you go.
See, guys, we're all smarter than calculators. You know, AI and all that, not coming for us. We'll be perfectly fine, I swear. Either way, coming into this possible last round here is Disrupt. Still have a chance to lock this out inside of regulation. TSM find that successful round and that previous one that we were just talking about on this top floor defense. Now, they're going to be defending the top floor yet again here, but obviously this is going to be a split hold instead. We've been seeing TSM prioritize a lot of play around the soda machines upstairs, and that's worked out extremely well for them, especially given what they've been able to do with the, we'll just call it the Malusi player that's been playing on the admin staircase.
So, again, we're just going to constantly update you guys on the standings since obviously it's the last day here, and things are changing with each round. If TSM wins this round, they are secured fourth place because they would be a guaranteed 13 points, and that Disrupt would only be able to gather two, so that ties them up with Dark Zero and SSG. I don't know how that three-way tie would end up working overall. The analysts will have that information for you, but that does mean that Disrupt will be unable to pass TSM at that point if they take this to OT.
Yeah, that's why we pay Jesse. They pay us to talk about what's going on right now. There you go. Yeah, you guys handle the number crunching and stuff like that. We don't do math live. Is like that's like.
I mean, I've been doing it for a couple rounds here. To be fair.
Well, we attempted science live yesterday, and that one didn't work out too well, apparently. So you know, either way.
Disrupt.
First minute down now is Disrupt is beginning this clear. They'll have some good top pressure, at least info-wise, as to what's going on. They'll pop the first EE1D as well from Shuttle. As this is a west to east clear, TSM holding on to admin yet again.
Seeing how this round devolves once more. Attackers have located a bomb. TSM continuing to have pretty aggressive hold to the inside of admin. Iconic going to be on the other end of that potential assault. Oh, as well, just sniping out a drone as it comes jumping into his corner of the map right there. But still going to be revealed. However, still thriving upon those conditions as he's able to follow up that drone with a quick pick against J9O. That's going to knock out one of the two hard breach players that they have access to here. Oh, Merc! Trying to play aggressively here on the inside of admin, but he's caught out due to earlier intel. Mark with a great initiation gets Disrupt some of the early control that they need, as you're going to see they'll take control of projector, at least the back of admin, although I believe there may still be one little wrinkle here. However, seeing as the players seem to have pretty unconcerned control over the second floor, I believe that is going to be TSM fully rotating out and now playing into the site.
Oh, this could be really, really bad. I think that Disrupt more than likely need to pressure downstairs because look at the amount of nitro cells that TSM have right now. With 30 seconds left, this is going to get to be extremely, extremely problematic. Chala has a nice angle here to prevent the hop inside of the teller's window. Disrupt currently still setting up upstairs as it seems it's all hands on deck at this last moment. Nice setup here from Achieved. He'll get some good reads on where people are playing around. Chala going to drop the angle as well as he gets the nitro cell prepped, but there's a lot of soft destruction done to this floor, which means there's a lot of angles that Iconic can work as well. Damage dealt to achieved as the last EE1D goes off. They'll find him. Iconic gets him through the verticality. Nitro Cell out. It doesn't bag Retro. Is this plant looking to go down?
Oh, no.
Geo's got another one coming out of thin air, but it's not able to secure it either. That's going to be two big kills here for Disrupt. This is all down to Chala. He's trying to swing on through, but Iconic with two. He's able to close it out inside of round 12. Disrupt beat TSM, and they gather 0 points here on our final play day.
TSM now locked at 12 points. Disrupt shoot up in the meantime from 10 to 13, meaning that they are going to bump TSM out of the top four and bump themselves into it. Disrupt secure a fourth place finish inside of stage one of the NAL, and coming with that is going to be a much further upgraded prize pool. $18,500 now going to them on top of 275 SI points.
He had a huge MVP here for Iconic as well across consulate. 17-4-7. What a showing from him. He needed to step up when Disrupt needed him the most. We didn't get the usual showing that we see from Shuttle, but that's okay because Mark was also there to assist as well. I'm telling you, folks, throughout stage one, Disrupt, they might have had their up.